I was very excited when I heard that Ali James had just finished his version 2 of the vLinn drum machine. I did a comprehensive review of version 1 a while ago. If you've not already watched that video, I strongly suggest you do before watching this one. In this video, I'm going to concentrate on what the new features are in version 2 and how it differs from version 1. The main and most important update is that it's been completely rewritten to be compatible with multiple plugin formats and 64-bit systems. It is now available for Mac and PC in VST 2, 3 and audio unit format. vLinn 2 is now written in Ole Larkin's respected iPlug framework. Version 1 was made in SynthEdit with added custom code, a lot like Variety of Sounds free plugins. Many people will be very happy it's now 64-bit. Even though there's no performance improvement, some DAW's 32-bit to 64-bit bridging can be problematic. Let's get right in and compare version 1 and 2 side by side and explore the new features. On the left we have version 1, and on the right, version 2. They look very similar, but version 2 has a cool circuit graphic for your viewing pleasure. There are improvements in the way you can interact with the GUI. Double-click resets values to default settings. This is particularly useful with the tuning, as you often want to return to a more sensible pitch after experimenting with some crazy ones. Alt-click enables you to enter values precisely with the keyboard. Control drag enables precise control over the knobs and sliders. This is the same as it was in version 1. The pitch control can now be clicked and turned into a pan control. This is very handy if you're not running the plugin in multiple output mode, as it enables you to make a full stereo mix from right within the plugin. The original Linn drum was famous for having feeling and groove. One reason for this was that the stock snare drum had a little empty space before the sample, causing it to sound slightly late. This meant it had a laid-back feel to it. In the vLinn version 2, there's now an additional custom voice that's named Extra. This has a copy of the stock snare without the delay. This enables you to quickly program drum patterns that do not have the laid-back snare sound without having to modify your MIDI. The original delay on the snare also got longer as you tuned the sample lower, so the new version is even more welcome in these situations. The velocity modes change the way the vLinn reacts to how hard you hit your velocity-sensitive keyboard or electronic drum kit. It also changes the way it reacts to program velocity inside your DAW. Version 1 had only two velocity response modes, original and full. Original emulates the hardware and having only two velocity layers. So if you hit your electronic keyboard or electronic drum kit very hard, you get the loudest drum sound. Anything under that makes for softer sound. It is playing the exact same sound, only at a lower or higher volume. Full makes the vLinn fully velocity responsive, unlike the original hardware instrument. Version 2 adds full Linn and full EXP modes. These are full velocity responsive modes, but they react in either a linear or an exponential way. These are just technical terms that relate to how the vLinn responds to how hard you play your controller. You may have come across these exact same terms in your MIDI controller manual. This diagram shows you what they mean, but you'll need to play the instrument to discover the feel. Now you can use MIDI pitch bend to globally transpose the entire kit. This is really cool for live performance. You can go crazy like this. What the hell is an EEPROM, you may be asking? An EEPROM is a special type of memory chip that retains its contents until it's exposed to ultraviolet light. It stands for Erasable, Programmable, Read-Only Memory. It is where the drum samples were stored on the old hardware. As you know, the vLinn 1 and 2 can both load the EEPROMs from compatible drum machines. Now in version 2, all the EEPROMs can be replaced instead of only 7 of them. Also, you don't need to worry about the size of them when loading anymore. This is taken care of automatically now. We also have a nicer layout and improved graphics on the page with the handy Unload Custom EEPROMs button to reset back to the stock sounds. The vLinn has the LM-1 EEPROMs built in, but wouldn't it be nice to have the LM-2 and Linn 9000 sounds? That was totally possible if you downloaded the EEPROMs and loaded them in. Recently, there's been a takedown on the Linn EEPROMs that have always been freely available from the Electron Gate website. If you go to the old download page now, you get this. 4AT Electronics now seem to own the copyright for these ROMs. I assume they don't want people burning their own and selling them on eBay, cutting into their business. Well, of course, this copyright shouldn't really apply to the samples in other formats. After all, the web is full of free samples taken from the LM2 and 9000. If you click the link below, you can visit the original blog post and find a bank in .fxb format that will work only in the vLinn version 2. It features not only the missing Linn EEPROMs, but all the classic drum machines that are compatible with the vLinn, ready to go. The other machines will of course sound like they were played through the LM1 hardware, but that's not a bad thing for lovers of 8-bit retro drums. If you're watching 4AT Electronics, the EEPROM format is embedded into another data format inside the bank. It is unusable as is to write onto hardware EEPROMs. If you demand a takedown, of course I will comply, but it would be a real shame for the users of this software. Really hope you guys are groovy with this. This is a great update. For many people, it will be the first time they get to use this plugin, as it was only PC VST 32-bit in the past. I can't really think of anything important that's missing now, and encountered no bugs or problems during my testing. If there was one killer feature that could be added in the future, it would be tuning the kit drums automatically to note names. There's much debate on if this is overkill, but I found it's a fantastic technique to get the bass and kick to gel. There are of course many freed and paid for drum samples out there that provide these sounds, but as we spoke about in the original review, they can't provide the special tuning and filtering that the vLinn provides. What is missing from these raw vLinn sounds that the sample libraries may have included is outboard processing to make them sound like the records we probably want to emulate the sound of. I think that half the fun is doing that yourself, and in the process making your own sound. Running the bass drum out through some old consumer cassette deck should get you very close to the 80s sound indeed. There may be one lurking in your attic right now. vLinn's GUI and features offers plenty of opportunity to experiment and play about with the drum sounds that the sample libraries don't provide. It's easy to set up multiple outs from your door and process each sound individually. It really is a much more fun experience than using samples, and that's what it should be about. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. To help support me making more, please join the Learn Digital Audio YouTube channel, check out my blog, and even more importantly, have a look at my Udemy courses.